Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I have a new card making video and I will be sharing 3 cards using products from the latest release by Waffle Flower. This is actually part of a blog hop. There are lots of giveaways and tons of inspiration. Make sure to visit my blog to find all about it. So these are the 3 sets that I will be using for today and I will be using the matching dies as well. And let's start with the first card for today where I will be playing with the Birthday Kitties stamp set. I will be playing for the background with the confetti stencil. You will get those 2 stencils in the set and it consists of 4 areas that when you layer one on top of the other, it creates the whole confetti background. And since you are supposed to layer those stencils one on top of the other, I'm going to make my life easy and I will use the silicone mat here so that I can align both the stencil and the paper on the top right corner. And if you take a closer look on the stencil, which is really hard to catch on camera, there are engraved colors there, which are actually just a suggestion. However, I'm going to follow them exactly so you can see how it works. So for the first layer, it says blue and I'm going with the blue shade here. I will be using my Distress Oxide inks for all the coloring. You can use any brush that you like, any blending brush to apply the color. I just find it easier since they are so tiny areas to work with my finger dabbers. And also notice that I did align the paper as well as the stencil on the top right corner of my mat. This way, when I have to rotate the stencil and place it again in the perfect position, I don't have to fuss around. I just know that by laying it on the top right corner, I'm good to go. So I did the second layer with green, then I went with pink, and finally I'm going to finish it off with the last area, and I will go with yellow here. You can, of course, play around with different color combos. You can even go monochromatic if you like, and you can even use glitter through that, which is something that I will do for the second page, just to add a touch of shine. Now, in the new release, there is also a die that cuts out exactly all those confetti pieces. You can even lay it as it is, going to match perfectly with the stencil. There are lots of things that you can do with mixing and matching those products, but I'm going to leave it as it is. I find it really beautiful, and I'm going to use a rectangle die to cut it out. I'm going for a slimline card, a mini slimline card. This size is quickly growing into me, and it becomes one of my favorite sizes to work lately. And now it's time to do the stamping. I will be using the birthday kitties. You will find many kitties along with many sentiments for birthdays. 2 of the kitties are actually a mirror image, which means that you can play around with that. You can make one of those spinner cards if you like, so you have images for both sides, or even you can make a window card, and when you open up the card, you can see the back, which is going to look just fine. Anyway, I'm not going to make any of those type of cards, but I am going with those 2 mirror images. They do have the exact same shape, but they don't have the exact same design. If you look closely, you will see that they are holding different designs of presents. I am going to color everything with my alcohol markers, and I grabbed my tree blends, which are my favorite lately. I get a lot of questions about those alcohol markers. These are by Crafters Companion, from the Spectrum Noir collection. So anyway, I am going to color everything, of course, inspired by my cat Ginger, and I'm going to use the matching die to cut it out. Now, since this is a mirror image, there is only 1 die included in the die set. So I'm going to use ones to cut out the cut that matches with the shape. And then for the mirror image, I'm going to lift the cut towards my light, which is what I'm doing here. I'm just working outside of the frame, and then I am aligning the die at the back. I'm going to secure it with some washi tape and run it through my die cutting machine. So when I place it on my platform, you see there is no die, but there is a die actually hidden at the back and secured with a washi tape. You will see that once I run it through the machine, it's going to work just fine. The easiest way to do that, of course, would be to first cut out the shape, flip it at the back, and then stamp and color your image. Sometimes I just like to do things the difficult way. And you can see how it would look if you stick them back to back. So anyway, for this card, I'm not going for that look, and I am planning to have those cuts as if they were jumping from the side of the card. When you use the confetti stencils, you will find that it leaves an empty gap. This is perfect for stamping your sentiment. I went with one of the sentiments from the same stamp set. And as I'm putting things together, I do have to add some foam tape at the back. I just wanted to talk a little bit about the coloring. This is where I realized that I didn't like the combo of the card on the right. It is green and red, and it kind of reminds me of Christmas. If I had to do that again, I would definitely use two different colors. But anyway, I'm just going to go with that. I have a yellow panel here, which is 6 1/4 by 3 1/4, and this is going to be the finished size of my card. I'm going to stick that directly on top of a pre-folded white card. I always like to have white on the inside of my card so that I can easily write my message. I'm also adding some highlights here and there, some dots, just some finishing touches. I'm also going to add some crystal gems just to add some shine, and I'm going to call this card done. Here are some close-up photos on my mini slimline card, and again the size is 6 1/4 by 3 1/4. So that was the birthday kitties stamp set, but there is a puppy kitties stamp set as well with matching dies, which I'm going to play with for the next card. For this card I'm going with a long dog, and there is also a mirror image for this design. There are also more mirror images for the puppies included, but I'm going with a long dog, which I'm planning to make it even longer than it looks at the stamp. So let's start. I'm going to stamp that twice, and I'm going to color it using the exact same colors. Again, I'm going with my alcohol markers. The idea here is to use the front part with the head from one image, and then all the way up to the cupcake, and then the bottom part from the other image, and you will see how I'm going to put them together. So first I will use the matching die to cut out both my images. And then I'm going to work on a panel. This is a navy blue panel, and I'm going to create my background again using the same confetti stencil set that I used in the beginning. This time I'm going again with oxide, distress oxide inks. And if you haven't tried that, distress oxide inks work beautifully on top of dark cardstock. And you can see here that you can even see yellow. This time I'm going for a more masculine color combo. I started with yellow, I'm going to go with green now, and I don't even dip the brushes on an ink pad. I know that I use these finger dabbers for my oxides, and they still have some ink on top of them, so I don't even bother to grab an ink pad sometimes. Now I'm also going to use blue. And there is also the fourth layer that I need to apply color, but instead of using distress oxide ink for the fourth layer, I decided to go with a shiny paste. You can use glitter paste, you can use Nouveau Mousse, any type of paste that you have that is going to add some shine. Here I'm going with glacier paste, and the color is Quicksilver. I'm applying it over the openings with my spatula. Always pick up the product with the back of your spatula. It does make spreading it around easily. And then I'm going to put back in the jar all the excess. And I think it binds everything together nicely. It adds some shine on my background. And I hope that the camera catches the shine. This glacier paste dries quite quickly. So anyway, I'm going to work on another panel here, which is bigger than the previous one. I did ink up the edges with a darker color, and I did use the same colored cardstock, but since I didn't find any darker one in my stash. So first I did use faded jeans, and this time I'm going with black suit, and these were both distress ink. For the sentiment, I went with a stamp from the same stamp set as the puppies, and I used this stitched rectangle to cut it out. This is from the A2 Lazy Layers die set. And I'm going to use foam tape at the back of my panel so that I can pop it on top of the darker one. Now, the finished size is again 3 1/4 by 6 1/4. And of course, I'm going to stick those panels on top of a pre-folded white card, since I always like to have a white inside on the card so that I can write my messages. I'm going to place at the center the sentiment, and then on the left and on the right I'm going to tuck behind the dog. This way it's going to make to give the illusion that the dog is longer, and of course I have to add foam tape at the back of the dog to pop it on my card. I always like dimension, so I'm going to stick everything down. And although I'm quite happy with how long the dog looks, which was the look that I was going for. I don't like the top right corner here. It looks unbalanced since it doesn't have something there. So this is an afterthought. I'm going to use the balloons from another doggy. I will stamp them and color them. I will use the matching dye to cut them out. And for the balloons, I went with this green that I did use for the cupcake and the hat of the dog, as well as yellows. And I always like to repeat the colors on my images. This way I kind of bring everything together. And I placed them on the card as if the dog is holding them with his tail. I'm not going to add anything else on the card. After all, it does have that beautiful shine at the background. And here are some close-up photos. For my next card, I'm going to use the stitched diamond panel die, and I did cut it out from white cardstock. I absolutely love this background. It gives you the option to tuck in between those little windows lots and lots of small leaves and flowers for a really beautiful card. And I'm going to use lots of images from this Simple Stamps stamp set. There are matching dies available as well, which I'm going to stamp and cut out. Now, since I don't know from the beginning how many of those stems and flowers I will need, I'm going to stamp a bunch of them. I'm going to color them with my alcohol markers and cut them out. I'm going to work with a vanilla card base today, so I'm folding the crease there, making sure that it's going to lay nice and flat, and then I'm going to place on top my panel. For the panel, I will use foam tape at the back, and I'm going to bring in my big roll of foam tape, and I'm going to use my scissors to cut it into thinner strips so that I can easily stick it at the back. As I'm going to place this panel on top of my vanilla cardstock, although they are not so contrasting colors, white and vanilla, however, you can still see the difference with that dimension, and I absolutely love the effect. And now I'm going to bring in all my cutouts, try to place them in different areas. I'm just auditioning here, I'm not sticking anything down. And after I'm happy with the placement, I can go ahead and stick everything down with my glue. Now there are so many different ways on how you can play with this panel. You can have pattern paper at the back and you will be able to see the wonderful colors coming through the windows. You can also ink up a background and place it there. I just went clean and simple for today, but I'm sure you can find so many different ways on how you can use that. Now this is a lovely card, it's perfect for any occasion, just add a sentiment. I decided for my sentiment to spell the word hello, and for that I did use the Retro Outline Alpha die, which I absolutely love. I am using it on a project that I'm sharing tomorrow on my Mixed Media Tuesday as well, and I absolutely love the font as well as the outline. So anyway, I'm going to ink up the bottom with a little bit of pink. I'm trying to get the same shading as I have on my flowers so that everything is matching nicely, and I'm going to stick them along the bottom of my card. And I'm just aligning the letters along the stitching line at the bottom, which makes it super easy to have them nice and straight. As a finishing touch, I will spread all around the card a few pink gems. And here is a close-up look on the last card for today. Absolutely beautiful. So I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. You will find a full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area. And don't forget that this is part of a blog hub. Blog hubs for a new release are always fun because you get the opportunity to see all the products in action. It helps you decide if something is the best for you. You get tons of inspiration, plus you have a chance to win prizes. You will find there all the info regarding the blog hub. So these were the projects for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all tomorrow with my mixed media project.